Quanti applausi! Ma quanti siete, ragazzi? Grazie! Radio Ali Blu. Come ci si sente dopo aver raccontato un'esperienza? Un'esperienza bella. Ci si sente bene. Raccontateci quell'esperienza, perché a volte riviverla con un racconto a qualcuno può renderla magicamente eterna. Durante il giorno ascoltiamo tante parole, siamo bombardati di messaggi, di parole che destabilizzano il nostro stato d'animo. Qua a Radio Ali Blu vogliamo sentire parole belle e attendiamo le tue parole belle. Radio Ali Blu, la radio che ti fa volare.
Theatre presents Skin Deep. I've been talking to him online for years. We met on a forum for lonely souls. He understood me. Most people did. He was on the other side of the world. I was afraid to ever show a picture of myself, but believing I was ugly, he was the same. He didn't feel I was going to be good enough for him physically. I always refused to Skype. He was the same. He didn't talk about age, he didn't talk about income. All we talked about was ourselves, our real selves. I know I understand you, I said to him one day in a message, a fifth year of our relationship going by. I know you're the one for me. You wouldn't say that if you saw me, he replied back. I could feel the pain in his words. I was turning 35 soon. One day I would want to step out of the shadows and be seen. But by the only one who could see me from behind his face, I was trapped with him. Do you believe skin beauty is skin deep? I asked him. One day he replied in the chat. No, do you? I don't know how to continue. Tell the truth, I'm just as bad as other people in my life. I judged a book by the cover. I was just too afraid to admit it myself. No. Hallie, I'm dying. I froze up when I saw him type that. I felt so cold, self go cold, an emptiness of despair running my veins to my heart. Of what? You don't want to know? I love you, I typed back, but the words seemed so meaningless. I was screamed. I said out loud to myself in my empty apartment, I love him. Please don't die, I said to him. My fingers typing the words as so fast as tears reached my eyes. I am not afraid. For you to die. I'm not ready for you to die. Would it mean anything? We know nothing about each other in real life. Tears rushed down my cheeks. I typed, afraid of reflection of my third degree. Burned face showing from the mirror away. Meet me and tell me I'm beautiful. Raised a date. I didn't like stepping out in public. I was ugly. Since the fire scar on my face at the age of 12, no one would look at me. That's why I knew I was not beautiful. Not me, but maybe he would see me. Me and not the skin. Me and not this deformed duckling that never goes out, got to spread its warm wings. I said I'd meet him at the airport. He agreed to travel across international borders. I waited in a seat at the airport's arrival station. Then I saw him approach. He's a frail, elderly old man. His skin wrinkled with eyes full of tears. You look beautiful, he said to me. I smiled and replied, that's all I wanted to hear. He sat down next to me, took my hand. We remained silent until the stars appeared in the sky.